Wow, does that morning sun feel good on my face? And what a beautiful, beautiful morning just to get outside and to enjoy the birds singing and the gentle breeze. It's just a beautiful morning. This morning I woke up to a text. A very dear friend of mine, known for many years back in the military at the Air Force Academy where I was stationed, that she had died during the night. This morning, of course, reminded of the 100,000 plus women and men, children who have died from the coronavirus. I'm also reminded of the 350,000 plus who have died from the coronavirus globally. And I'm thinking as well of George Floyd and his death. And of course, every day reflect upon all the faithfully departed. So St. Paul's reflection today out of Acts chapter 23, verses 6 through 11, were all about his hope in the resurrection. In fact, he was before the Sadducees and the Pharisees, and the Sadducees were not believers in the resurrection. The Pharisees did believe in the resurrection. But anyway, it was an intense trial. In fact, he was rescued because they thought that he was going to be torn apart. And he heard God's voice that night that said, "Take courage." The resurrection is much more than believing that there is life after death. Resurrection, hope in the resurrection, means that we believe in a new way of living, a new way of life. Resurrection means to embrace a new way in being in relationship with God, with others, and with creation. Well, it all boils down to this. As believers in the resurrection, in God who raises everyone, those who have died from this coronavirus, for my friend, for George Floyd, and for all who have died, we believe in a God who certainly manifests the true signs of resurrection because God's mercy, compassion, and justice will have the final say. We complete our season of Easter this Sunday, celebrating Pentecost. So I invite you again to participate in the 9-day novena. And if you haven't done so, to sign up with Teresa, it's in after this video, with her 3-hour retreat this Saturday. I think there's already 29 people who have signed up, which is really, really excellent. Okay, so Paul heard from God those final words, "Take courage." Take courage this day. And all the things that are with you and within me, no, there's new life and resurrection in them. St. Mary Magdalene, pray for us.